Om Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Welcome to the day 25 of our reading from the Krishna book. Hope you all had a lovely weekend. We were on Friday on this part of our katha that Krishna had to expand himself as the cowherd boys and the calves, because all the calves, they went missing, and the boys who were herding them, that is the gopas. Now, how to contain this situation, Krishna had to think of something, and what happened is he expanded himself into all the cowherd boys and the calves. And Krishna, at the request of Balaram, explained to him that why he had to expand himself, because the boys and the calves were stolen by Brahma. So that by his expansion, the mothers of the little gopas would not find out they went missing, and the calves were also missing. Now we'll begin. While Krishna and Balaram were talking, Brahma returned after a moment's interval. Now this is very interesting. Brahma's time is not at the same scale as our time. So according to the duration of his life, we have information of Lord Brahma's duration of life from the Bhagavad Gita, which is 1,000 times the duration of the four ages, which is the four yugas, or which is 1,000 times 4,320,000 years. They constitute the Brahma's 12 hours. Similarly, one moment of Brahma's is equal to 1 year of our solar calculation. So I'll repeat, which is 1,000 times 432,000 years times the four ages. This is the duration of Brahma's life. So one Brahma during his duration of life will oversee all the four yugas in one cycle, which is a Satyug. After one moment of Brahma's calculation, Brahma came back to see the fun caused by his stealing the boys and the calves. So Brahma just took a moment's gap, but according to Earth's time, it was 1 year. But he was also afraid that he was playing with fire. Krishna was his master, and he had played mischief for fun by taking away his calves and boys. He was really anxious, so he did not stay away very long. He came back after a moment of his calculation. He saw that all the boys and calves were playing with Krishna in the same way as when he had come upon them. Although he was confident that he had taken them and made them lie down asleep under the spell of his mystic power, Brahma began to think, all the boys and calves were taken away by me, and I know that they are still sleeping. How is it that a similar batch of boys and calves is playing with Krishna? Is it that they are not influenced by my mystic power? Have they been playing continually for 1 year with Krishna? Brahma tried to understand who they were and how they were uninfluenced by his mystic powers. But he could not ascertain it. In other words, he himself came under the spell of his own mystic power. The influence of his mystic power appeared like snow in darkness or a glowworm in the daytime. During the night's darkness, the glowworm can show some glittering power, and the snow piled up on the top of a hill or on the ground can shine during the daytime. But at night, the snow has no silver glitter, nor does the glowworm have any illuminating power during the daytime. Similarly, when the small mystic power exhibited by Brahma was before the mystic power of Krishna, it was like snow at night or a glowworm during the day. When a man of small mystic power wants to show potency in the presence of greater mystic power, he diminishes his own influence. He does not increase it. Even such a great personality as Brahma, when he wanted to show his mystic power before Krishna, became ludicrous. Brahma was thus confused about his own mystic power. In order to convince Brahma that all those calves and boys were not the original ones, the calves and boys who were playing with Krishna transformed into Vishnu forms. Actually, the original ones were sleeping under the spell of Brahma's mystic power. But the present ones seen as by Brahma were all immediate expansion of Krishna or Vishnu. Vishnu is the expansion of Krishna. So the Vishnu forms appeared before the Brahma. All the Vishnu forms were bluish color and dressed in yellow garments. All of them had four hands decorated with club, disc, lotus flower and conch shell. On their heads were glittering golden helmets inlaid with jewels. They were bedecked with pearls and earrings and garlanded with beautiful flowers. On their chests was the mark of Shri Vatsa. The arms were decorated with armlets and other jewelry, and the necks were just like conch shells. The legs were decorated with bells, their waists with golden belts, and their fingers with jeweled rings. Brahma also saw that upon the whole body of each Lord Vishnu, beginning from the lotus feet up to the top of the head, fresh tulsi leaves and buds had been thrown. Another significant feature of Vishnu form was that all of them were looking transcendentally beautiful. Their smiling resembled the moonshine and their glancing resembled the early rising of the sun. Just by their glancing, they appeared to be the creators and maintainers of the modes of ignorance and passion. Vishnu represents the mode of goodness. Brahma represents the mode of passion and Lord Shiva the mode of ignorance. Therefore, as the maintainer of everything in the cosmic manifestation, Vishnu is also the creator and maintainer of Lord Brahma and Shiva. So we see here that Lord Brahma and Lord Shiva, they have been created by the Lord to help run the universes. After this manifestation of Lord Vishnu, Brahma saw that many of the Brahmas and Shivas and demigods and even insignificant living entities down to the ants and very small straws, all moving and non-moving living entities, were dancing around Lord Vishnu. The dancing was accompanied by various kinds of music, and all of them were worshipping Lord Vishnu. Brahma realized that all of those Vishnu forms were complete in mystic power, beginning from the anima perfection of becoming small like an atom up to becoming infinite like the cosmic manifestation. All the mystic powers of Brahma, Shiva, all the demigods and the 24 elements of cosmic manifestation were fully represented in the form of Vishnu. By the influence of Lord Vishnu, all subordinate mystic powers were engaged in his worship. He was being worshipped by time, space, the cosmic manifestation, reformation, desire, activity, and three qualities of material nature. Lord Vishnu, Brahma also realized, is the reservoir of all truth, knowledge, and bliss. Satchid Anand Vigraha. He is the combination of three transcendental features, namely eternity, knowledge, and bliss. And he is the object of worship by the followers of Upanishads. Brahma realized that all the different forms of boys and calves transformed into Vishnu forms were not transformed by mysticism of the type that a yogi or a demigod can display by specific powers invested in him. The calves and boys transformed into Vishnu murtis or Vishnu forms. Were not displays of Vishnu Maya or Vishnu's energy, but were Vishnu himself. So this is very significant. The cows and the boys were not just the manifestation of some kind of power of Vishnu, but they were Vishnu himself. They were the Lord himself. The respective qualifications of Vishnu and Vishnu Maya are just like fire and heat. In the heat, there is the qualification of fire, namely warmth. And yet, heat is not fire. The manifestation of the Vishnu forms and of the boys and cows were not like the heat, but rather fire. So they were not just the energy, but the source of the energy itself. They were all actually Vishnu. Factually, the qualification of Vishnu is full truth, full knowledge, and full bliss. Another example can be given with the material energy. Objects, which is same thing, which are reflected in many, many forms. For example, the sun is reflected in many water pots, but the reflections of the sun in many water pots are not actually the sun. There is no actual heat or light from the suns in the pots, although they appear like the sun. But the forms which Krishna assumed were each and every one full Vishnu. The specific word used here, The specific word used in this connection is Satya, Jnana, Ananta, Ananda. Satya means truth, Jnana is full knowledge, and Ananta is unlimited, and Ananda is full bliss. So this is, we can say, a kind of description of Lord, which is truth, full knowledge, unlimited, and full bliss. The transcendental forms of the Supreme Personality of Godhead are so great that the impersonalistic followers of the Upanishads cannot reach the platform of knowledge to understand them. Indeed, the transcendental form of the Lord are far beyond and reach of the impersonalists, who can only understand through studying the Upanishads that the absolute truth is not matter or is not materially restricted from Krishna's expansion into Vishnu's form. Lord Brahma could not understand by his limited potency that everything movable and immovable within the cosmic manifestation is existing due to the expansion of the energy of the Supreme Lord. When Brahma was thus standing, baffled in his limited power and conscious of his limited activities, within the 11 senses, he could realize that he was also a creation of the material energy, just like a puppet. So I think this is where Brahma had the realization that he was also part of the energy of Lord. He was created by the Lord himself. As a puppet has no independent power to dance, but dances according to the direction of the puppet master, so the demigods and the living entities, which is Devi Devatas and all the living species, are all subordinate to the Supreme Personality of Godhead. As it is stated in the Chaitanya Charitamrit, the only master is Krishna, and all others are his servants. The whole world is under the waves of material spell, and beings are floating like straws in water, so their struggle for existence is continuing. But as soon as one becomes conscious that he is the eternal servant of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, this maya or illusory struggle for existence is immediately stopped. Lord Brahma, who has full control over the goddess of learning and who is considered to be the best authority in Vedic knowledge, was thus perplexed, being unable to understand the extraordinary power manifested by the Supreme Personality of Godhead. In the mundane world, even a personality like Brahma is unable to understand the mystic power of the Supreme Lord. Not only did Brahma fail to understand, but he was perplexed even to see the display which was being manifested by Krishna before him. So we shall stop reading here and we will conclude this chapter, The Stealing of the Boys and the Calves by Brahma, tomorrow. And you can see that there are so many stories in Srimad Bhagavatam, because this Krishna book is Canto 10 or the Dasham Skanda of the Bhagavatam. So because it is narrated in stories, it's so interesting and it's so baffling at the same time for us to read about these pastimes, these leelas. But when you start understanding that who is the Supreme God in this universe, of this universe, not just ours, but all the cosmic manifestations, your curiosity or your inquisitiveness is satisfied by hearing of these pastimes. And the more and more we hear about them, more and more we clear our inside of our hearts, and we are able to develop a bigger satisfying relationship with the Lord. Because don't forget that in this Kali Yuga, the good and bad, they both are in us. So if we feed the bad dog, the bad will come out from us. And if we feed the good dog in us, obviously the good will come out. So we have got the good and evil both residing in us in this Kali Yuga. So we should make most of our time on this earth as a human being and try to understand more and more about the Lord and fulfill the purpose of this life. That how come we came as this, in this life as humans? There's a purpose for us. If we lose this, we don't know in the following births, are we going to come as which species? Are we going to go into the lower life or into higher life? But the human life is the only life where you have been given all the faculties by the Lordships to understand Him, to hear Him, to remember Him, and to serve Him. No other species around us has been given this opportunity. So let us make most of these opportunities given to us by Sri Sri Radha Madhav and serve them to the best of our abilities. And try to make our home life, our work life, our family life, spiritual life, everything very, very auspicious. Tomorrow is Nirjala Ekadashi. So everyone who is going to be aspiring to keep Nirjala Ekadashi, please start drinking more water and look after yourself so you can carry on with that tomorrow. In this part of the world, it's a little bit easier for us that we can do this. So let us wait for the Nirjala Pandavikadashi tomorrow. And hopefully it'll be a wonderful day for all of us. We shall resume our reading tomorrow. Hare Krishna.